Hello world, it's Rahul. Welcome back guys to machine learning tutorial, and today we'll be going to discuss support vector machine. So guys, I have divided this complete tutorial into several parts. So this session will cover basic intuition of support vector machine, and we'll see how we can mathematically solve support vector machine problem in upcoming video. So agenda for this video will be hyperplane, logistic regression versus SVM, margin, support vector, linear separability and non-linear separability. So guys, first let's understand what problem statement we are going to solve over here. Then only we can understand different algorithms and their functionality. So suppose here our problem is to categorize the unknown point between different classes. Just to add one thing, that we can solve both classification and regression problem by using support vector machine. But here I'll discuss classification only, and we'll discuss regression also, but that will be later on. So guys, let's say we have two classes, that is class A and class B, scattered on the Cartesian plane. Now I have to categorize this unknown data point, whether it belongs to class A or class B. So this is just a simple classifier problem which we have already solved using logistic regression or k-nearest neighbor. Then why we are learning this new algorithm? So I'll definitely answer for this question, but not now. First, let's visualize the problem and see how sparsely our data set has spreaded in the Cartesian plane. So guys, if you can see, we have class A and class B scattered on the graph. So in case of logistic regression, what we were doing earlier is to create a straight line between these two classes, so that one can clearly understand that if any of the unknown point comes below this line, then that point will be categorized as class A, otherwise class B. So we were simply calculating the data separable straight line for this type of problem. Now suppose if we have n dimensional data points, or let's say we have 3 dimensional data, then how we will create this separable line? So in that case, we have to create a hyperplane, and which is nothing but a line in case of two-dimensional data. Now question arises, how could we define a hyperplane? So let's look at two-dimensional case first. So guys, the two-dimensional linearly separable data can be represented by a line. The function of the line is y is equal to ax plus b. Here, we'll rename x with x1 and y with x2, and we will get it as ax1 minus x2 plus b is equal to 0. Now, if we define x is equal to x1 and x2 and w is equal to a and minus 1, then we will get it as w into x plus b is equal to 0. So this is the equation of line, and it works for any number of dimensions. So guys, this is not the only case to draw a hyperplane. As we were also drawing hyperplane in logistic regression, then how it is different from logistic regression? So let's first understand the difference between these two algorithms. So logistic regression helps to solve classification problems, separating the instances into two classes. However, there is an infinite number of decision boundaries, and logistic regression only picks an arbitrary one based on the value of m and b parameters. Now, if you can see on the screen, suppose blue points are categorized as 1 and red points are categorized as 0. So guys, for point C, since it's far away from the decision boundary, we are quite certain to classify it as 1. But for point A, even though we classify it as 1 for now, since it is pretty close to the decision boundary, if the boundary moves a little to the right, we would mark point A as 0 instead. So guys, logistic regression doesn't care whether the instances are close to the decision boundary or not. Therefore, the decision boundary it picks may not be optimal. As we can see from the graph shown on the screen, if a point is far away from the decision boundary, we may be more confident in our prediction. Therefore, the optimal decision boundary should be able to maximize the distance between the decision boundary and all the instances, that is, maximize the margins. So here support vector machine came into picture. So guys, one thing to notice here is the objective of support vector machine is to find the best line in two dimensions or the best hyperplane in more than two dimensions between different classes. And this hyperplane is found through the maximum margin, that is, the maximum distance between the data points of two classes. Now, let's say we have two classes scattered on the graph, and to separate the two classes, there are so many possible options of hyperplanes that separate correctly. As shown on the screen, we can achieve exactly the same result using different hyperplanes. However, if we add new data points, the consequences of using various hyperplanes will be very different in terms of classifying the new data point into the right group of class. So what we do, we try to create a parallel line to both sides of this hyperplane, considering that this line must be passing through one of the closest data point, and we call it as support vector points, because only these two points are contributing to the result of the algorithm. And guys, one thing to add, this line can be passed through more than one point. So you can see this point is nearest to the hyperplane in class A. So in support vector machine, our focus is not just only to create a hyperplane, but to create two parallel margin lines as well, with the maximum distance between them. Now, when I say distance should be maximum, then what does that mean? So let's denote class A distance from hyperplane to margin line as D1 and class B distance from hyperplane to margin line as D2. And if I add these distance, then D1 plus D2 will be our marginal distance. Now let's see why this distance should be maximum. So guys, here if you can see, we don't have any data points in between of these margin lines and hyperplane. But in test data, suppose some of the data points come over here. Then also, it can categorize that data point according to the plane drawn. So we prefer this marginal distance as maximum to generalize the model on test data set. Now, if we draw margins for all the hyperplanes, what we have drawn earlier, we can see that L1 is the best hyperplane with the maximum marginal distance. So guys, now we have complete intuition like how support vector machine algorithm works, how it creates hyperplane and margins, how it separates and categorizes the unknown data points. But till now, you guys have seen the problem which will work only for linearly separated data. What if this data is non-linearly separated? And when I say linearly separated, that means if you are able to draw a straight line between two classes and separate them apart, then that is linearly separable data. Let's say here we have another Cartesian plane where data is scattered in a such way that we cannot separate them with the help of a straight line. So suppose if I draw lines like this, then in any of the cases, I can't separate these data and categorizes it as any of the class. So, in order to solve this type of problem, we have kernel techniques used in support vector machine. So it simply converts low dimension into high dimension, what shown on the screen, so that we will be able to draw a hyperplane and separate these data points. So guys, that's it for now. I'm hoping that you have clear understanding of support vector machine algorithm, and we will discuss a lot of mathematics used for solving these attributes in next session. Till then, thank you guys for your time. Do like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon to get the latest updates. Happy learning and stay safe.